Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are divorce lawyers warning Prince Charles crying. The Times this morning splashed a tongue-in-cheek, light-hearted article across two of its pages entitled Meghan, How the Royal Family Necessitates You. It's just one of a series of a piece across the UK media about Prince Harry's rumored new love. Meghan Markle is a stunning 35-year-old divorced Hollywood actress with whom and as a result, me single and fun-loving Prince is apparently smitten. To be fair, it's made apparent in the piece that the evidence for romance is quite thin. They seem to wear the same bracelet and both were in Toronto and London at the same time. Still, if the Times has published, perhaps we can be more confident that there is a result me fire beneath the smoke. The paper asks rhetorically whether Miss Markle is Princess material. Perhaps she is and perhaps she isn't seem to be the conclusion. But there we part company. As a divorce lawyer with well over 30 years experience of seeing once happy couples part company, my own rhetorical follow-up question would be, if the worst comes to the worst, is she divorce material? Both rhetorical questions do matter, and as a result, it is the public interest to speculate on both. Prince Harry is arguably, for a host of people, perhaps the most prevalent member of the royal family after the Queen herself. He really is one of the main causes we all love the royals, whether in this country or abroad. He's down-to-earth, friendly, cheekily imperfect, but capable, alas, result of pulling off fantastic achievements, just like the Invictus Games. His evident love of his grandmother and of service to the country cannot be faulted. He's one of the best of the royal family brand. And what he does well helped to secure the future of the monarchy in the UK and across the Commonwealth when his grandmother is no longer around to do as a result. For a host of people, alas, a result, despite his position, he is quite simply one of us. And we desire him to be happy. We desire him to carry out his duties with a gorgeous wife smiling beside him, raising a family. We desire a rosy future for a young man who grew up with his fair share of broken marriages across his family, as well as the tragedy that befell his mother. Of course, the acrimony between Prince Charles and Princess Diana preceding Paris was of their own making. Let's at last a result not forget, despite all the privileges they had, so no matter who you are, no matter what you possess, mistakes can still be made. And in the case of Prince Harry's parents, the fallout was felt across the world, and it rocked the institution of monarchy. So like those close members of his family, who Prince Harry marries is important not just for him, but for the whole monarchy. As a result, me business, which he cannot escape, whether he likes it or not. Marriage can be unpredictable and success is certainly not guaranteed. I've been to weddings in the past and found myself claiming no, 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 as the bride walked down the aisle. On another occasion, I predicted marital doom after a best man speech, and I was right on both occasions. So my first thought on hearing of a marriage, on potential marriage, is often, if it doesn't last, what kind of divorce might follow. Take a look at how divorce is conducted US style, not behind closed doors, as we do it over here, with two parties tightly battened down by the court orders. Consider the international courtroom confrontations conducted by Madonna from New York or Angelina Jolie from Los Angeles. In this country, prenups are still not legal, but let's assume a US wife to be of Prince Harry signed one, which I guess she would be required to do to try and retain a lid on divorce if, heaven forbid, one ever take place. It would probably be rubber stamped by the courts back in LA where she comes from, and in the event of this hypothetical divorce, I don't doubt the English courts would uphold the agreement. There would be an exception of a result privacy, but I don't claim matters would end there. Why would a US citizen wish to stay in England? Wouldn't she head straight back home, taking any descendants with her? Of course, without the prince's consent, taking the descendant with her would be illegal. What would be the destitute guy then? Start proceedings in this country and LA. The forlorn figure of, as a result, called Stuck Mama is a family figure to family lawyers. She's the woman unable to leave her ex-husband's country and return home. Be in danger. They had descendant together. Some possess written to this blog. Some stick it out, unhappy, and as a result, others throw in the towel and surrender their descendant to the ex, and then only rarely see them afterwards. Even Madonna, with all her wealth, was not immune. Consider the added difficulties that would be faced by a stuck dad, alas, as a result, placed to be one of the heirs to the British throne and one of the most prevalent members of the royal family. But far more unpleasant, there would be the apparent and ever-present hazard of a US citizen's power to talk to the press while going through a divorce, probably by a highly supportive LA-based lawyer. The risks presented by this option should never, ever be underestimated. The value to the media of whatever she would say would be immense, and undermine it could potentially endanger to an unsuspecting prince, and to the monarchy could be incalculable. Such a headline-grabbing divorce, if it ever placed, would make those of Diana, Fergie, and Angela and Julie all look tame by comparisons as a result. So if Prince Harry ever truly claims of getting married for real, and frankly is one of the most illegible person in the world, what's the rush? He would be wise, in my view, to ask himself this simple question. What kind of divorce would it be?